sur le canot, on va faire une table. Nous sommes.
Yeah, yeah. My name is Ebi Sowa from Australia. I've lived in this community for the past 3-4 months now. This is the area that's one of the areas that, you know, it's just a suburb of Freetown. And here is Ojukwu area. According to the area, you know, people have been here during Christmas or especially occasion times to see how people enjoy. But we are down to Ojukwu, one of the slum-down areas, and asking people how they feel about this Christmas. So this is brother of mine who's genial, and another guy, your name Sheikh Yusuf. Yeah, I say brother of mine's name. So, Mr. Joseph. So, I just want to ask, you know, them what is happening, so they can able to tell us a little bit. I know what is happening because I live in the community, but they know more because I'm a bit better off than them. You know, every day they are going out and see what they can get. Suffering. They have children, women and children. As you can see the area, you know, a bit area, but I believe it's okay. So we are trying to help people by the end of the day. If only I have the help, I will come down here by the end of the day, one day, to help these people that we are talking to. Junior or Mr. Yusuf or Mr. Yeah.
You are celebrating Christmas.
Yeah, he said he's not happy the way he celebrated Christmas.
Yeah, I see things very terrible in my life. My smaller brother just don't die with his family. All.
Oh.
5 days to the five picking up. The five, six life don't go.
He's just saying here that one of his brother lost his family. He lost his family and my brother with his five children. And wife with this Ebola.
But me saying a man, I can always try for help, speak to people and say, let me always try for belief. He's saying he tried to tell me the instructions already in the beginning.
Yeah, he's trying to say here that, but at first people wasn't really believing, but as currently now people are saying,
still believe, you know?
This is one of the things that's happening in this country. And look at him. He lost his brother with the brother's wife and the five children from Ebola. It's terrible. You say, and how people, we see this man also in the community, we think that because of the brother has got an Ebola, maybe he also, you understand? Yeah. Some people we trying to ignore him. Yeah, but I hope these are the people they need help. I believe that when I get back over to Australia, people will be there maybe to help these people. Yeah. Okay, Sheikh Yusuf.
We are the sickness is real and has caused so many destructions in our community and of course as a country, as far as the country is concerned as a whole.
Yeah.
We really seeing sudden deaths, of people who were seen.
No, come this way. Yeah, when I come together.
These are all the things that also into consideration really. Of course, we all have to abide to the rules and instructions of the country. We have already believed that the sickness is real.
Oh, since I know.
We are believing, but some people are stubborn to believe.
Yeah.
But within our community, we try our best to sensitize them.
There is due to the advices of the government. To avoid body contact and other things, because of course, we take to the way we have already
believed. Yeah. And I believe that this is not a man-made sick. as people say, it's a man-made success. It's reality. Ebola is real.
It's real. It's not man-made.
Yeah, it's not man-made. You can't blame the government. You understand?
I don't believe there is any man-made sick that destroys a whole of the
family. Family, yeah.
Seriously.
Wipe up one whole a family home.
Five of them.
You see?
Five of them, six. See, I was also affected by the disease. I'm also a victim of the disease.
Really. Yeah.
Having my elder sister, she and her husband have been affected, including two of their children.
Yeah, this is Sheikh Yusuf is just serious. Talking about also
been affected by the disease.
Yeah, one of the victims, you know.
I've lost them all in our family now. So we are not even happy of celebrating the Christmas.
Yeah, because
Christmas
also the government
season is very, very sad for us.
Yeah, the government is trying to protect people. So
yeah,
that's why
yeah.
He said no one should go out there. Yeah, I know. I've been in this country last year I was here. Though Christmas wasn't, but the fever was there around November. You know, people were getting ready for Christmas. Yes, this is a country that they love people.
Yeah, we love strangers.
You understand? They love strangers, they love people, we love to one another.
Holidays with our strangers.
Yeah, but this Ebola crisis has made everybody's fear. No one knows who, you know, who has the sickness. So everybody is afraid. Even myself, I'm standing here in this video. Yeah, I'm just risking my life. Yeah. To see the people. Yeah. To tell the Australian people that I came here to risk my life to ask some of these people in this hand to be a volunteer, you know, so that they will see on TV and believe that I was here to help the people, to try my own best, ask people, I went to the rural areas about three months ago. I was given some things to come and donate to my village, and I took those things there and donate to the women and children there. That video you guys will see later of the day. So I'm here. As time goes on, I believe that this sickness, God will help us, and
Ebola must go.
You understand? And this country is a religious country, both Muslim and Christian. They are praying very hard, you know, working with the government. The religious people are working with the government to eliminate, sensitize, you know, their people. I love this country, and a lot of people, they love this country. And you also, I'm trying for you to see this video. I hope after Ebola is done to this country, you will come and see these people, and they will be happy with you. They will hold you nicely, and you will see some people will tell the story, those who have lived to tell the story. I believe, you know, they will tell you. And this country, we will stand, they will stand back on their feet and help the country as a whole. God bless. Thanks very much. How are you, brother? Yeah. Now, my name is Abi Soa. Me not Sierra Leonean. Me not Mende by tribe. I was born in this country. But, you know, I struggle during the war. Yeah, myself, me own family members, then die. So I able to escape. Tell God, I go get myself now Australia. You understand? Yeah, so I be done camp. But we are coming self, the Ebola hold me here. I not get chance for go yet, you understand? You know, but they may give me some things then we I been can't I not remember self for Ebola. You see, some people that I say I want to help my country of origin. So I been take something then I go we then give me I go donate and I mean village. You see. But the Ebola be done wild. So even the plane we I can't wait. Oh, you know, because of state of emergency, they be done stop for Canada. So now I mean myself they are in the community. You find myself no people's concern. You understand about this sickness. So because where they go back yonder, I want to let people they know say yes, I don't come on at this country. and people then really then they suffer. Not to government they make them they suffer. Okay. But now man made not to man made sickness. Now God self create this epidemic.
And yeah, God made disaster.
Yeah, you see. So the government they try very hardly for let you know this sick go. But sick way you know they see. You know the fighter. You understand? Like war in those days, you can see gone.
Yes.
They are able to escape. But this one is a spiritual sick. You can't see it at all. It's so up myself and I make with the pass around and the axe, you know. So that tomorrow I don't kind of myself. Maybe I pray God say by God in power. Let God give me the upper hand where I go. I get people them with them with able help. Whatever I get, you understand? This man know me. I will come back in this community. And I call sure the one away them in the end of the video. Say, where them people there, where them people there. When I go normal, oh this man be don't care. You understand? So now that may
okay.
Come around.
Yes. Now.
Yeah.
Now what are the purpose of this?
What are the purpose of this? Yes, now I'm gonna explain to you.
Yes, concerning about this Ebola.
Uh-huh.
Because
yeah.
Now we serious problem now Ebola. Now problem at alone right now. Yes. With the armed people them. Now yeah. You don't see a video. Okay. You mean just after Ebola, what thing are the betterment of what thing you can do to we so what are the better of this week we try for cancer?
Okay. He's just trying to ask me what is the because the main problem here is Ebola. You understand? Mm-hmm. So what is the main purpose of me as videoing these people? And after Ebola, what do I have in mind or in return to come and do for these people over here that I'm interviewing? Okay, I'm going to speak my little dialect here. We call it Creole, with general people talk. As I say, you understand, eh? We are the tribe for talk here. Myself, I've been calm. Before I serve this Ebola, I've been there under. Yes. You understand? Yes. I've been a think of for can donate some things. I can go to people. I can bring container. Mm-hmm. You understand? Then home use for sale. I they come with some things then where I donate that money they now they use back. And where I don't go donate to them people then. Mm-hmm. I don't sell whatever I sell. For able to get back where I go back. Mm-hmm. That money they are they use back for help tell people that let them help me. Mm-hmm. Where they help me that money they are they use them. For low container again, for can't donate, then whatever I put inside, I sell again, I will be able to hold that money in my hand. So, this trip where I come, waiting them give me for can't donate, I don't go donate, you understand, to the village. So, you understand, I don't believe, me now, I was born Pujang district, so I mean him, so, you understand, you see, but I don't believe, think of how this Ebola. You understand him? Though it been real, not been physical, it go expand, it go spread, and it go day up to this time.
Yes.
You understand? So now, it make maybe now go hold me back, say make a day, and make a see for myself, so that we are they go tell the white people. You understand? Eh? Then go believe exactly. Say no, this man is from the line. It's from the front line. It just not like war.
Yes.
A journalist come. You understand? Yeah, they see how bullets, you know, things that happen people. So, like say, me now one of the witnesses, where are they?
Yes.
You understand? Eh? So, where I go tell white man, the white man goes, say, no, this man not really talk. You understand?
Okay, now.
Uh-huh. Me not pass. Yes, so, now. Hold this. You understand? Yes. Eh? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Now.
So, now me. Yeah, put them in your pocket. Put them. So on Amina, hello, you can try so.
Yeah.
So on Amina, like a journalist or whatsoever, I mean, they're at the front line right now here. You understand? I believe, see, the people that we are going to commit by God in power, you see, whatever help, we they able to help. You understand? I promise you, I will come back now this place.
Yes.
By God in power. God will give me the upper hand.
Yeah. And okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now,
yeah.
The problem,
yeah.
I glad you for all who you talk. Now,
yeah.
If you go for go show this video, now the cry where you meet me, now ground with where you don't can see now.
Yeah.
We cry, we will get.
Yeah.
Ebola don't harm me. Because,
yeah.
You know, I'm me alone for kill me.
Yeah.
But, he harm me people that me kill them. Now, me on arm with Ebola harm me.
Yeah.
Right now. Now Salonia, we don't do it. You can take 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, you never cook. Now you host. Because of Ebola starvation.
Now, people then they die.
Yeah.
The same thing, economy don't drop. Oh, the same thing, work no day, school no day, no education because of all the name of Ebola.
Yeah.
Now, what thing we need now this country are, we they pray that let Ebola go and left free. Make it not go now any other Africa country, make it not go now any other Europe country, make it go to God will it come out, make it done now this world. Yeah. Now, if it Ebola done now the world.
Yeah.
But what thing are the way for now, after Ebola, maybe whether in 10 years time, 15 years time, God will help we again because they help all day to God.
Yeah.
But in 15 years to 20 years time, if he the wait people they don't help we because we the Africa they will fall. If the wait people they don't help we in 15 years time still, Ebola go down to me. After we the Ebola done, in 15 years time, the only way Ebola done did, you know, for make a cover up.
Not true.
The easiest thing we go make we will forget small. In a way the international world help we, if the international world not help we, my brother. Shalom go to zero up to 30 years with a zero by the name of Ebola. So if he go for go play this video, then the way people they know say, now this the video reports to them for say you don't can do them, you don't can see, you don't see anything that happen at Shalom right now. Now they bury people them by dozen.
Oh,
because one gram of tokade they load 5, 6, 10 people them. Then go there, they begin pull one by one, they hibahanda, like fish, then they go pull now trawler, fishy or so. Will that not be ever happen? Because this epidemic, no ever expect say this kind of thing they happen at the world. We not expect that at the world. Not for Africa alone. Not for Africa alone.
Yeah.
So if this video they won't give any report, this problem, Salon, after Ebola, let Ebola done tomorrow. In 30 years time, if the international world not help we did zero because education are zero for now.
Yeah,
education are zero. So all things zero, everything fall.
Now picking and they get belay because of this Ebola.
Everything zero.
Because they know they go school.
So if he this video, let this video give the report say now Salon, if he don't help we don't have lucky. So now God and them when at the front line, now they no more now with the pray so let the help you. Beside the help, they are not nothing. So
Thank you. Yeah. I will later on talk about this. Whatever he has saying here, you understand? Whatever he has saying here, it's very saddening because I was born in the center. Yeah, but currently these people need help. Yeah, even after the Ebola, still this country need help. From now to 10 to 15 to 20 years time, because it has, you know, great deeply holes, just like a cancer. When someone is having cancer, how the cancer is, you know, terrifying your system. Please, I need help. These people need help. Not me, can say that I need help, but to come and help them. Not to help myself, please. And I hope one day this video will play, maybe CNN, SBS, Al Jazeera. I'm praying that one day this video will play, and the people will be sitting here and watch that. Yes. After the car, so I came to this country and trying to help people. Thank you very much, and I hope that the future of these people currently, God will help them. But for now, the future of this country and the people, the poor people, is bleak.
Totally.
Please, they need help. It's just like crying for town during the war. So this is the Ebola cry for town. Please. I need help for this people. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you.
Yeah, you have time. Yeah.